Everything I do is with intention. It's the week of my Enchantress week. It's the week where I feel the most powerful and I feel like I can really contribute to change for my clients. As I reflect on my expansion, I think about just a few months ago where I couldn't even fathom the thought of taking on more than 2 clients a night. And to now be in a space where I can work through 6 clients and feel the joy that it brings me is so telling about traveling from one point to the next, about setting goals, looking forward to where you want to be with the understanding that it is only in the here and the now that you can actually get to point B. It doesn't happen overnight. It's not magic. It's hard work and dedication to yourself, day in and day out. A couple of weeks ago, my friend Lucia referenced an episode on a podcast that I was formerly on that she likes to listen to ever so often. It's an episode where I talk about the ego. And I realized that I've never broke down that work, that explanation of the ego on this podcast. And I also realized that I've been using the word ego so much in that I haven't explained to you my version, my understanding of the ego and how I see it. Initially, one of the reasons I was so resistant in breaking down my level of understanding of what Eckhart Tolle calls the ego is because I had already broken it down in another space at another time. And when I broke down the ego for me personally, I discovered something inside of me that I had not previously discovered to the depth where I had discovered it in that moment. I completely found my voice. I was able to see that my perspective, while it might be a bit different, it was easy for me to explain and it was easy for other people to grasp. Shortly after that, the universe completely shut me down and I wasn't able to exercise that power for a really long time after that. And I think there was a big part of me that resented that episode where I found that power. I am going to introduce my understanding of the ego via Eckhart Tolle's teachings. This is something that for me is crucial in the level of expansion. When you want to grow spiritually, this is a very fundamental piece to help you grow. I'm also going to add the link to the episode where I explained the ego 2 years ago to date. It gave me the chills when I realized that 2 years ago to date, I explained this topic, and here we are now. I'm being called to explain it again from my perspective today, but I also don't want to take away from the power of how I explained it 2 years ago, because when I listened to myself, I was shocked, really, at what I was teaching myself. I couldn't believe it. I couldn't believe that I was listening to myself 2 years ago and I was teaching myself a very important message 2 years later to the date. And it just goes to show that it's not coming from me, it's coming through me. I also want to clarify that the term the ego, I use it the way Eckhart Tolle teaches it in the book, The Power of Now, but this is a summed up explanation of my personal experiences when using his perspective of the term ego and being able to identify it in the way that he has so perfectly, in my personal opinion. But I do have to say that I want to pay tribute to The Peaceful Warrior by Dan McMillan, and I also want to pay tribute to The Book of Knowledge by Don Miguel Ruiz. And so this sums up Eckhart Tolle's definition of the word ego from my personal perspective, not that this is his exact teaching. So we're going to take a short break, and when we come back, we're going to talk about the enemy within. 2.0. Return to the one.
Return to the one.
What is the ego? The ego is who is in charge when you are unconscious. The ego does not live in the present moment. The ego lives in the past and it lives in the future. The problem is that the past and the future are not real, but the ego tricks us into believing that it is real. As a matter of fact, the ego lives as if the past and the future are now. Collectively, we are addicted to thinking it alive. Thinking. All we do is think. And when we think, we are feeding the ego. It is impossible to be thinking and be present here in the now. It is only when we are fully present that we are disconnected from the ego. If we are living in the past, then we experience extreme sadness, or in worst cases, we experience depression. If we are living in the future, then we have anxiety. The emotions of sadness and anxiety are direct keys of how often we are living in ego. And what's really sad is that most of us are almost always functioning in ego. Our society is completely built on the ego. It entertains the past and it entertains the future. It hardly ever entertains the present moment. What's happening is that we are in repetitive cycles of different levels of anxiety or different levels of sadness. Because our emotions are what is manifesting more of the same experiences. Let me just repeat that. We are in repetitive cycles, living different levels of sadness and anxiety, because our emotions are what is manifesting more of the same. Remember that our emotions are the reason we manifest. And so if we are in constant ego space, then we are constantly attracting that energy where the ego lives, where the ego thrives. It's like watching a hamster on a hamster wheel. It's inside this circle where it's running. It's literally running in circles, really. It's going through that cycle over and over again, running as fast as it can. It is not until the hamster sits still that it is able to pull itself out of that cycle. That is exactly how the ego works. It keeps us in a cycle because the ego can't live in the present moment. It feels threatened the moment you try to bring it in the present moment, that you're constantly wanting to go back either to the past or move forward into the future. I want you to envision a straight vertical line. This vertical line that I'm going to describe, you can look it up. It's expanded consciousness, a vibrational scale. It's a 20-year study that was conducted by scientists. They were able to measure frequency. We use the word frequency all the time. Well, scientists were actually able to measure the emotional frequency that we go through. So on this vertical line, at the very bottom of the line, there's a vibrational frequency that's measured at 20. That emotion that is tied to the frequency level 20 is shame. Shame is the very worst emotion that we can feel. And what is so sad is that a lot of the victimhood mentality lives in the space of shame. The next level up is a level vibration of 30, and that is the emotion of guilt. If we aren't constantly appeasing someone else, we feel guilt, which is so twisted because the only action of importance is to put ourselves first. But society has taught us that we need to put others first. Otherwise, we will feel guilt. It's almost like a trap. The next level of emotion is measured at a 50, and that is called apathy. Apathy is known as indifference or detachment. It means not caring what happens either way. We've been using the word detachment spiritually a lot lately, and I think it's very important to highlight that detachment in a spiritual space does not mean apathy. Detachment, spiritually speaking, is letting go of any expectations or illusions. The next level up is measured at 75. And that is grief, complete pain for the loss. It doesn't mean pain necessarily for the loss of someone else. It can also be the loss of something, some idea, something that is keeping you attached to a false illusion. Now we're going to push all the way up to the top of this vibrational scale. We just discussed the lowest four emotions that you could be feeling. Now we're going to go all the way to the top to the highest four emotions you can be feeling. At a vibrational level of 500, we have love. At a vibrational level of 540, there's joy. At a vibrational level of 600 is peace. And enlightenment is measured at 700. You can see how the lower level of this scale embodies darkness and the upper level of this scale embodies light. The majority of us are operating from the dark space of this scale. We are constantly fueling emotions that embody the darkness, that embody a lower frequency. The ego is what is keeping us on the lower part of this vibrational scale in the darkness. A way to know if you are in ego is if you're feeling these emotions. You can move in and out of the ego. The ego can't live in the space of peace, joy, and love and enlightenment. It breathes, it lives in the lower vibrational frequency. So let me just go over some of the emotions and their opposites. So if you're living in a light vibrational energy field, a light frequency, a higher level of consciousness, you feel connected and you feel present. If you're living in a lower scale, a dark space of emotion, the opposite of that is emptiness and absence. Harmony, clarity, and awareness are emotions that belong in the light. Direct opposite of that is distorted perception, illusion, and expectations. A quiet mind, release, pain relief, and energy is all part of the light. Direct opposite of that is a busy mind, full of drama, and pain, and drained. Embodying the higher level of frequency, consciousness, promotes healing to yourself and to all of those that surround you. Embodying the darker emotions on the lower level frequency is illness to yourself and to all of those that surround you. When you embody this lower level of frequency, you are constantly going to attract people that wake up your pain body, that fuel it, because you're moving in a hamster wheel. You're moving in that space. That's what you're going to attract. It's really important for us to understand that if you're operating from that lower frequency, it is so easy for the ego to trick us into believing that we have found love, that we have found happiness, that we have found peace. They're usually temporary pleasures. A vibrational frequency that is tied to enlightenment, that is detached to the ego, has the ability to stay there without the pain body being awakened, meaning that it's not a temporary peace that is brought by something that you've obtained outside of yourself. It's not temporary happiness because you just bought this purse that gives you a status that you've been seeking. But once you have the purse, once you use it, it's gone. It's already dissipated. That's a false love. That's a false peace. That's a false happiness. That is what the ego is chasing. A lot of the times we diagnose the lower end of the frequency to mental illness or even the devil and a form of possession. And while that is correct on some level of understanding, it's also not just chalked up to a small group of people. It's actually the majority of the human species, really, that is living in this vibrational frequency. It's just that most of us know how to contain it and how to mask it. And we become completely submerged into this lower vibration where we become locked in. Are you in the past or are you in the future? Sometimes we can be tortured so much from the past that our mind takes us fast and furiously to the future, only to be met by complete anxiety. There's never any relief. It's going back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. It's so important to do constant self-check-ins. What am I feeling? What am I observing? It's really important for us to understand that those emotions that we feel are not us. And we identify so much with them. Like if I say, I am so mad or I am so sad, I'm completely attached to the ego and attached to the emotion, not aware that I am not sad. That's not who I am. I might be feeling sad. I might be feeling mad, but I am not those emotions. This is a condition of collective emotions that were here before we were even born. We were born into unconscious parents. We were born into an unconscious society, and everything around us has been structured for us to live unconsciously. We are literally trying to dismantle beliefs that were put in place before we even came here. And I personally think that that's why we are here, to dismantle these beliefs. I believe that that's our mission here. That's why we're called to this work. That's why we're called to the spiritual journey, because we are like secret agents trying to tear all of these beliefs down so that we could really find what it means to be free. It's exactly like the Matrix. What pill do you want? The red or the blue? The ego is war mentality. It's why we kill each other and why we kill ourselves. It's why we're constantly trying to tear each other down. The ego needs to feel completely separate from others. My race is better. My religion is better. My business is better. My spiritual growth is better. The ego can live anywhere. That is how the ego feeds itself. It is an energy that can only thrive in separateness. Separateness. That's why it has to separate itself and live in the past, or separate itself and live in the future, because it cannot sustain itself here and now. The drama, the pain, the fear, the hate cannot sustain itself here and now. The only thing that can sustain itself here and now is Source, and that is where joy, peace, and true love live, is here and now, this second, this moment. What are you doing right in this moment? This breath you just took, the exhale you just released, this is it. This is all we have. It doesn't matter what happened 5 minutes ago. It doesn't matter what you think might happen 5 minutes from now. It does not matter. For some people, this understanding is like a flip of the switch. But for most of us, it takes real work. It's reprogramming. It's constantly checking in. It's meditating in stillness. It's meditating in motion. It's journaling, it's praying, it's exercising. The journey looks different for so many. It's what is being called, what is right for you right now in this moment. What is right for you? Stay vigilant of the enemy that you have within. And by just staying vigilant, you yourself are already aware. By identifying programs that are coursing through your DNA, that cause constant pain and are having you relive past experiences, or if you're constantly worried about your future and what is going to happen next, just the fact that you are being vigilant and able to identify those two extremes is already placing you at a certain level of consciousness. It's already placing you at a level where you can take action to heal properly. And healing for you is going to look completely different than it does for your sister, for your neighbor, for your friend. You have to simply honor what's right for you. I do believe that painful experiences need to be reprogrammed, because we have been running on old, outdated programming for centuries. Like I mentioned, even before we were born into this program. And so it is important to find the space to take the time to identify and to continue the path, to continue the work, and to continue healing. The ego is what is in charge when you aren't being conscious. If you are not living in the present, and your programming is constantly in the past or in the future, your ego is living through you. You are completely unconscious. Thank you so much for listening to this week's episode. I really hope this understanding is helpful. It's something that I have to revisit myself. I want to just really give a special shout out to Lucia for reminding me of this episode. And I totally believe wholeheartedly that is not a coincidence that exactly 2 years ago I was explaining this. It's crazy to me how much I learned, how much I'm still healing, how much more work I have to do, and the lessons that I've learned from that point in time right before I fell into a deep sadness, a long period with the ego, and then finally found my peace, found my joy, found my love, and found my voice again. On March 30th, I will be having a conversation at a very special event that is being put on by Christina Garcia from She Grows, We Grow. We're going to take a deep dive into the shift of collective consciousness that is taking place right now. These are such important conversations. I have so much gratitude for her for putting on this event. And then I also just want to give a really special shout out to host committee members that are assisting her with putting on this event, Esoteric Essa, who we just heard from recently, as well as Cindy Kanek of Divina. I can't wait to open circle, to open space to talk about this because I feel like I have so much to say about this topic. And I feel like it's time for us to start having these really challenging conversations that are thought-provoking and can also begin to break down limiting beliefs, change our perspective, and propel us into expansion. You can find direct link to purchase your tickets on the Let There Be Luz bio. May the light within grow stronger. Return to the one.